Hey students, it's Mr. Moldenhauer here. What we're going to do right now is I'm going to kind of go through Act 1, Scene 5, the part you should have been reading. First thing I need you to do when you get your packet out, you should have your packet, open up to page 11. We're going to do the definition right here of foreshadowing. If you look at foreshadowing, we've talked about it already. We've had a little bit of foreshadowing. Romeo's bad dream where he dreams he's going to die. Of course, that one. But foreshadowing is a literary device in which a writer gives an advance hint of what's later to come in the story. So we've already had that example with Romeo. We're going to get a few more today. Tybalt's going to foreshadow something, of course, when he's so mad. And Juliet's going to foreshadow something as well. So that's a definition right there that you want to include in your page 11 examples. One more thing that you can also do, of course, is if you're ever moving too fast, you can always go back on this video and look at something a little bit more. The next place we want you to open up to is lines 54 through 92. This is Tybalt spotting Romeo. He spots Romeo and he's ticked. He's very ticked that Romeo would dare come to a Capulet party like that. He's so mad that he goes to his uncle and he says, basically, "Do you see this, uncle? This is Romeo, our enemy, here at your party. I want to kill him. Let me do this." In these lines, you can see that Lord Capulet, though, he has a sort of a surprising reaction to this. If you look at line 65, Lord Capulet actually says, "Be content." He's like, "Chill out. I've heard good things about this youth. Verona brags of him. He looks like a gentleman. He's well-governed. I wouldn't, for the wealth of all this town, do him any harm in my home." In other words, he's saying, you're going to have to deal with Romeo. And Tybalt does not like hearing that. He's like, "I will not deal with him. He's a villain. I will not endure it." And Capulet says, "Yes, you will endure it. Don't be shameful." If you look at Tybalt's last lines, though, especially lines 89 through 92, Tybalt says, "I will withdraw," so he's dealing it, "but this intrusion shall now seeming sweet convert to bitterest gall." In other words, Tybalt saying, "I will get my revenge on this Romeo eventually." Looking at lines 93 through 111, this is Romeo and Juliet's meeting. They are flirting here, people. They are flirting big time. Romeo do a lot of talking about their palms and their hands because this is the first flirt that they do. They hold hands. They touch hands. And they compare their hands to pilgrims. Pilgrims are people who would go to a holy place, a church, or a shrine to worship. And they're saying their hands touching are like pilgrims praying. And, of course, a courtly thing to do would be to kiss a person's hand, which is what Romeo does. And they're flirting back and forth a little bit with this. I like Romeo's line, especially down there in... I think it's about line 103. "Then, dear saint, let lips do what hands do." In other words, Romeo is saying, let our lips do what our hands are doing. Our hands are touching. Let's have our lips touch too. Which Juliet, of course, agrees to, sort of. She says, "Saints don't move." So in other words, she's saying, "My lips aren't going to move. But if you want to move your lips over here, go for it." Which Romeo takes her up on. He, of course, kisses her. And he says that he has sin on his lips and he wants to be like a pilgrim who would give up their sins. Romeo wants to give up his sins to Juliet. And so he gives her this kiss, this sin. Now, Juliet's like, "Well, great. I got sins on my lips now. Take that sin back again." And so Romeo, basically she's telling Romeo, "Now I got sin on my lips. You better take that sin back." And Romeo obliges again and takes the sin back by kissing Juliet again. This is some heavy flirting going on here. They're kissing already. Of course, then Juliet has to leave really quick. Her mom calls for her. And so she quickly, Romeo asks Nurse. He's like, "Who was that girl?" And he realizes a big problem. She is his enemy. Juliet, when she finally gets back with Nurse, she's like, "Who is this guy?" And when she realizes this is Romeo, she realizes it's a big problem. You look at Juliet's line, especially 140. She says, "This will be a big misfortune. This could be a disastrous problem in the future." All right. That's what I've... Make sure you got the questions done. Make sure you're working on doing that. Fill out all your questions in your booklets, and there you go.